Hi everyone. Well, I just came inside from picking some really delicious garden fresh herbs for dinner. Oh, these smell so good. But tonight I'm gonna make some stuffed butternut squash. So I thought I would just bring you along in my kitchen, show you the recipe. Super easy, really delicious, warm fall recipe that we love. Hopefully you like it too. So it comes together really quickly. You just need a few really simple ingredients. Of course, you need the star of the show, butternut squash. Hopefully you have some that you grew in your garden. But if not, just run down to Trader Joe's, the grocery store, and pick one up. And we love to add some meat to it to make a little bit more hearty, like a meal rather than a side dish. So I've got some sun-dried tomato chicken sausage here. This is the kind that's already fully cooked. And I have some feta cheese, because we all know everything's better with feta, right? Got some walnuts. And my garden fresh herbs I'm using are oregano and parsley. Oh, they smell so good. The best thing about this recipe is you can really customize it to whatever you happen to have on hand. If you're not a meat eater, just leave the meat out, whatever herbs you have growing, and you could use another kind of winter squash too as well. Well, the first thing I'm gonna do is to bake my butternut squash in the oven. Now, most people when they bake butternut squash, they cut it in half first when it's raw. I personally don't like to do that because it's so hard. It's really hard to cut through. You have to have a super, super sharp knife, and I'm always afraid I'm gonna slip and cut my finger. So to make it a lot easier, what I like to do is just bake it on my baking sheet whole. So I have my baking sheet lined with parchment paper, but a really important thing is to make sure that you poke a hole in it somewhere on the skin or on the bottom to allow the steam to escape so you don't have a big explosion in your oven. Now, I prefer to poke a hole in the bottom with a little knife. It's just really soft on the bottom here. Slides right in. There we go, ready to go in the oven. I've got my oven heated to about 400, and it'll probably take about 60 to 90 minutes to bake. Well, my butternut squash is all done baking in the oven, and look how beautiful it looks. Nice and brown and blistered skin. Well, I've been letting it cool here on my countertop so I could handle it easily. And here's a really good way to tell if it's done. I just like to poke it with a fork. I do this while it's in the oven, actually. See how easily that goes in? That means it's nice and soft on the inside, ready to scoop it out. So let's cut this baby open and see how it looks. Okay, I'm just gonna make a simple little cut lengthwise down the middle here. See how easy that was to cut when it's nice and cooked as opposed to when it's raw? Wow, look at that gorgeous orange flesh. Oh my gosh, I just love the color of this stuff. And I'm just gonna use an ice cream scoop to scoop out the seeds and all the stringy stuff. And then I'm just gonna scoop out the flesh. It's gonna be nice and soft. I'm gonna scoop it out and put it into this bowl here. And I'm gonna leave the skin intact because I'm gonna put the butternut squash filling back in. So I'm gonna scoop this out. And I like to use the ice cream scoop. It really makes it easy to scoop all the flesh out. So I've got all my flesh scooped out. Doesn't that look amazing? Look at that gorgeous, absolutely lovely orange color. So let's make the filling. So easy to make. So we've got all of our beautiful, gorgeous butternut squash filling in the bowl here. So all I'm gonna do is just add a little bit of butter. You don't wanna go too heavy on the butter because after all, we are trying to eat healthy, right? A little bit of salt and pepper. I love to use fresh ground pepper. And just simply mash it up. It's not going to take much mashing because it's already super soft. You can see how soft it already is. You don't really have to do too much to it. There we go. Now I've diced up the chicken sausage and browned it in a pan. I'm going to go ahead and mix that in. Do about half of it here, about half a pound or so. Just stir it up a little bit. This is so easy and it smells so good. I absolutely love the colors. Okay, and then we're just gonna put it right back into our shells, our butternut squash shells. It's such a quick, easy recipe. Just dump it right in. Really makes a great, quick weeknight dinner. And I'll probably put like a salad or maybe some garlic bread or something like that with it. Right back into the shells.
Okay, and now comes just about my favorite part, the feta cheese. Sprinkle on some feta. Makes it look really pretty. Put as much or as little as you want. And I've got my chopped herbs here. I've got oregano and parsley, and I'm just gonna sprinkle that on top. You can mix it in, the herbs in with the filling too if you want, but this time I'm just sprinkling it on top. It'll save a little bit of extra for the side. And then I've got my walnuts. This adds a nice little crunch. Sprinkle those on top. And then I'm gonna pop it back in the oven for about 20 minutes till it gets nice and bubbly, the cheese is all melted, and all the flavors just kinda ooze together.
Now what I'm gonna do is pop it back in the oven for about 20 minutes so it gets nice and hot and bubbly, and then the taste test, my favorite part. Oh my gosh, this looks and smells amazing. Oh, I wish you guys could be here to smell it. The walnuts are nice and toasted. The feta cheese is nice and brown. It's nice and bubbly. Absolutely smells amazing. I'm gonna go in for the taste test. Oh, this is steaming hot. Mmm. Oh, wow. All those flavors really meld together. Oh my gosh, this is so good. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to wait till camera guy and the rest of the family gets home. This might be gone by the time they get home. This stuff is so amazing. So let me know if you try it, please, in the comments below. Let me know what else you'd like to make out of butternut squash or what your favorite garden fresh meal is to make this time of the year. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Wow, this stuff is so good. Mmm. Oh my gosh, delicious. Bye-bye.
It's ready, and if you can see here, when I'm poking my fingernail, I can barely get my fingernail through the skin, which is factor number 3 we can check off our list. So this squash is definitely ready for harvest. And when you harvest a butternut squash,